Welcome back, Tigers. In this video, we will show you how to import quotas using Data Loader. Manually adding quotas in setup under Forecast Quotas is not efficient, and it's really easy to make a mistake. If you have a larger sales team, this process could take a really long time too. We are going to learn how to import quotas in minutes using Data Loader. Let's go check out how to make loading these quotas easier. All right, so we're going to use Data Loader to import our quotas. We have a sales team that consists of 4 people, and we need to input quotas for the entire year. We have prepared this spreadsheet. We don't want to input 48 entries by hand into the Forecast Quotas tab. We are going to import these. You will need the user ID, the Forecast Type ID, the quota amount, and the start date to import these quotas. The sales rep name and Forecast Type name are just there to help us identify who these IDs are for. Now you can get the user ID from Salesforce. From the URL, we search for Roger Rohr here. I can get his ID from the URL here. You can also do an export from Data Loader on the user object and pull out the user ID in one column and the name in another and do a VLOOKUP onto your Excel file and get the IDs for your users that way. In order to get the Forecast Type ID, we need to run a query in the developer console. I'll put this query in the description below. You're going to, in the query editor tab, copy and paste, select ID master label from forecasting type, and then you'll hit execute. And then you will get a list of all the forecast types that exist in your org. This is the one that we created custom, the rev estimate by month. And this is the ID that we want to pull and put onto our Excel spreadsheet. We'll put that in column D here. We'll drag that all the way down for all of our sales team members, and then we'll click save. Now we are ready to use Data Loader. So we'll pull that up here. We're gonna run an insert, and we're going to click show all Salesforce objects, and we're going to insert records into the forecasting quota object. We'll click browse, and then we will open up the file that we prepared with the quotas and the user IDs and the forecast type ID. We do have 48 records, and then we're going to create or edit the map, and we will auto match the fields. So quota amount is correct, start date is mapped correctly. Our owner ID is gonna go against our user ID, and then our forecasting type ID. We'll click okay. Click next and finish. And then 48 records were inserted successfully. Now we want to create a report because we want to see that all the quotas were imported correctly, and we want to cross-check what we imported. Now, if you go to create a forecasting report, we'll go to all, we'll choose forecast, and we can see that we don't have a report type that is correct for us to use for this. We're gonna go create a custom report type. So we'll go to setup, go to report types. We're gonna click a new report type, and we're gonna go down to forecasting quotas. We'll put this in the forecast folder, and then we're going to make sure that it has the object we want, which is forecast quotas, and that's all we need. Click save. Now when we come back here, we'll refresh. We'll come to our reports tab. We'll click new report. And then we're going to change this to show all forecasting quotas. Our end date is going to be in the current fiscal year. We'll group this by our end date. And then we want to have our owner full name, our amount, and that should be good. We can group this by our sales rep as well. We can save and run this. Okay, we can see our totals by month, and then we're just gonna tie out this number here, 10,365,000. And make sure that that's what we see in our Excel file here. So if I total these up, I can see, yep, the sum of those is 10,365,000 as well. Now let's talk about a couple of things about the forecast tab and how it doesn't roll up the amounts for the managers. We're going to come to my forecast and I'm going to look at July through September. Now remember, I'm the head of sales and I've got two direct reports. I can't see any quota numbers. Now we can do a workaround, which we're going to show you in a future video, where we load quotas for the managers and then we filter them out of reports, or you can just set up a completely separate forecast type that does have the roll-ups for the managers so that they can see where they're at as a team in respect to their quota. If I click on Tara Hunter, I can see my individual sales team members, but I can't see where my team is at percent to goal as a team. So we will show you how to enhance Salesforce to show this information for your managers. If I click this hierarchy icon, I can then drill into each individual sales team member's forecast, which is a nice feature to have as well. That's it. That's a wrap. Be sure to subscribe to Blue Tiger Academy so you don't miss out on the next video we are working on that will show you how to create a dashboard for your sales teams and managers to use for pipeline and quota reporting. Let us know in the comments below if you have any questions or if you'd like to see a video on a different Salesforce topic. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.